shopping, we say, how much will it cost? And the true meaning of Christmas somehow becomes lost. Amidst the tinsel and glitter and ribbons of gold, we forget about the child born on a night so cold. The children look for Santa in his big red sleigh, never thinking of the child whose bed was made of hay. In reality, when we look into the night sky, we don't see a sleigh, but a star burning bright and high. A faithful reminder of that night so long ago, and of the child we call Jesus, whose love the world would know.
Of a king.
The baby, they fall.
of the day. Almighty God, you made this holy night shine with the brightness of the true light. Grant that here on earth we may walk in the light of Jesus' presence, and in the last day wake to the brightness of his glory. Through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated.
The first lesson is from Isaiah 9. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in the land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation, you have increased its joy. They rejoice before you, as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness. From this time onward and forevermore, the zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. Here ends the reading.
Thanks be to God.
The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary,
For you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. And his kingdom there will be no end. Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy, and he will be called the Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God." And Mary said, "Here I am, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Third lesson is from the first chapter of Matthew. Now the birth of Jesus the Messiah took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been engaged to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. Her husband Joseph, being a righteous man and unwilling to expose her to public disgrace, planned to dismiss her quietly. But just when he had resolved to do this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet. "Look, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel," which means God is with us. When Joseph awoke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. he took her as his wife, but had no marital relations with her until she had borne a son, and he named him Jesus. Here ends the lesson.
Thanks be to God.
Second chapter of Luke. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration that was taken when Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David, which was called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and the family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
lesson is from Luke chapter 2. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph, and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told to them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all those words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all that they had heard and seen, as had been told them. Here ends the reading.
Thanks be to God.
Story we have just heard. Only God could have written this story. Nobody else would ever have imagined such a story could take place. 2,000 years ago, a young girl, engaged, was asked to carry the baby Jesus. And when she and Joseph went to Bethlehem, because they were told by their government that's where they had to go, they went. One evening, When they got there, there was no room for them, and they were forced to go to the stable where the cows and the sheep, maybe the chickens, maybe the pigs were there, we don't know. She gave birth, and she placed it in a manger that had some straw around it. Was he cold? Did they have some clothes? They had what they called swaddling clothes, wrapped him up in some cloths to keep him warm and comfortable. And that's when the angels came out to the hillside and saw the angel, and saw the shepherds and said, ah! You've got to go and look. You've got to go and see what has happened. And so they left and left the hillside and went down into the city and went to that manger where Jesus was laying. What a remarkable story. Now, in the next couple of weeks, we're going to hear more of that story. So don't leave us. Come back and hear the rest of it, because it gets very exciting. But tonight, we celebrate the birth. We celebrate the birth of Jesus, God with us, Emmanuel. Praise be to God that never forgot any of us and gave us this Savior. Amen. Silent night, holy night. Joy to the world. The Lord has come. We will sing both these carols as we continue to celebrate this evening. Silent night, holy night. There are armies shooting at each other at this very moment all around the world. Sleep in heavenly peace. Silent night, holy night. There are children who are hungry and crying tonight. They do not know where their next meal is coming from. Sleep in heavenly peace. Silent night, holy night. There are families who quietly grieve the loss of a loved one. This night, a parent, a spouse, or a child who is missing this family at Christmas time. Sleep in heavenly peace. Some of us can't help but let the tears run down our faces as we sing the most precious of Christmas carols. Silent night, holy night. We might remember the days of our childhood when this night was a magical time, and the days of our youth when we had so many dreams that we thought our hearts would burst with gratefulness to God for our good fortune. For many of us, everything seemed so perfect, so right with the world. We didn't know. Silent night, holy night. What happened, Lord? Why do I cry with so many others this night as I sing this carol? Is my innocence gone? Do you feel and see the burdens we carry in our hearts? Are you heartbroken along with us over the conditions we find around the world tonight? There is so much separation tonight, Lord. We see divorce, corruption, anger, self-centeredness, and stubbornness. Some of us are experiencing loneliness, sickness, and hopelessness like we have never known. Some have had dreams shattered, lives turned inside out and upside down. tears flow so easily compared to other times when we have sang Silent Night, Holy Night. As we celebrate the birth of Jesus tonight, we are invited to imagine coming to the manger, just as the shepherds did, in awe and with haste, in response to the angels, to see what the Lord had made known to them. You who are listening and watching are invited to leave your joys and your burdens at the manger. Your hurts, your sorrows, your pains, the despair, the depression you feel, and all the frustrations of the last many months that you've had. When will school open for good? Not this off again, on again thing. When will we be able to go out and just be? When can I have a spur of the moment meeting with a treasured friend for lunch again? What can I plan further than just tomorrow? Will my unseen family be safe? Yes, we all need to reach to experience the manger, just as the shepherds did. Experience it with wonder and with the assurance that this is the Christ child who has been sent to comfort us, console us, to be the unseen friend to us, who will save us from all eternity. Leave your full hearts right here at the manger. If we could see how full they were, I imagine they are bounds of our loves and our cares and our worries and our concerns would be higher than the gifts that you piled up out in the hallway under the tree for the Kenan house. Gentlemen, just as the Kenan house men are overwhelmed at the gratitude of the enormous outpouring of gifts that we had for their families, know tonight that Jesus sees you just as you are. And Jesus is wrapping his arms around you in comfort and peace and consolation. He sees your loneliness. He hears those deep sighs. You know that tonight is different than any other eve of Christmas that any of us can ever remember. In a few weeks, we're going to pack up the manger for next year. We're just going to put it in a big box and put it away. What we really want to do is pack up the loneliness and the other feelings that we have tonight and throw them out with all the wrapping paper and the bags and the bows. How fast can we do that? We have no intention of saving them until next year. Yet we know that tomorrow, the sadness and the loneliness for some of us will still be in the living rooms, just as it's been there for the weeks and the months ago. You may be assured that they have been seen by the God-man of Jesus who went to the cross for us. Tonight we will celebrate the sacrament of Holy Communion together. We haven't done that very much this year. We shall envision all the beauty of the gifts that God has given to us to use for God's kingdom. Because of Jesus, we are able to experience the peace of forgiveness and reconciliation that this happens in an evening with the bread and the wine. Tonight, remember the gifts that have been given to you throughout your life. Know that when we present ourselves to the manger, we also leave ourselves at the cross. Lord, now I know I can sing joy to the world when there is so much mayhem going on around me. I can sing because you have accepted me just as I am with all my imperfections. Left at the manger, and at the foot of the cross. I can sing because you love me tonight and every night just the way I am. I can sing joy to the world, the Lord has come. I can sing sing, "Let earth receive its king," because I believe it. I want to thank you for the gifts that you've given us tonight. I can sing because I want others to know it and believe it too. Joy to the world. The Lord has come. Amen.
Thank you.
gracious God, you came to us as one unknown, bringing joy and salvation to the earth. Nourish us at your banquet table, that with all who welcome your birth, we may proclaim your peace, revealed in Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right in our duty and our joy that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and Merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ. In the wonder and mystery of the Word made flesh, you have opened the eyes of faith to a new and radiant vision of your glory, that beholding God made visible, we may be drawn to love the God whom we cannot see. And so with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. He was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And again after supper, he took the cup. He blessed it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "This is the new covenant in my blood shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Drink this in memory of me." Remember us in your kingdom, Lord. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Come to the banquet, because all is not ready. Those of you here, quiet. This is the body of Christ. Eat all of it. This is the blood of Christ that's shed for you. Drink all of it. May the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. The beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, but the darkness has not understood it. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. From the fullness of his grace, we have all received one blessing after another. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
You have heard. Merry Christmas.